My name is Rita Hargrave. I'm a geriatric psychiatrist from the University of California at Davis, and today I will be talking about dementia care in the African American community.
At the end of this module, you'll be able to.
The areas that I'll be discussing today are epidemiology, dementia risk factors, disparities in healthcare, assessment, and caregiver issues. Under epidemiology, population statistics from the Administration on Aging report that over the next 40 years, the number of people aged 65 and older are expected to double, and the number of people aged 85 and older is expected to triple. Now, among African Americans or Black or African American older adults, currently in 2008, let me go back over that. The Black or African American older population was 3.2 million in 2008 and is projected to grow to over 9.9 million by 2050. In the U.S., there are at least 5.2 million people with Alzheimer's disease. The incidence of Alzheimer's is almost twice as high among African Americans as compared to Caucasians. By age 65, over 10% of African Americans will be diagnosed with dementia. By age 85, 50% will be diagnosed with the illness. African Americans may be at greater risk also for mild cognitive impairment. This is an area that's become of increasing interest, looking for people who may be at risk for developing dementia at a later date, and perhaps in the future, interventions can really be focused on that at-risk population with mild cognitive impairment. And the data does seem to imply that African Americans also may be at greater risk for mild cognitive impairment. Now, vascular dementia is much more common in African Americans than Caucasian older adults. Now, in spite of these ethnic differences in the epidemiology of dementia, it would appear that genetic differences may not appear to be the primary cause for these ethnic differences. So what are some of the risk factors for African Americans around mild cognitive impairment and dementia? The risk factors that we believe are responsible for the increased rates of dementia among African Americans include their higher rates of hypertension and diabetes, fewer years of education of uncertain quality. So someone who received a sixth grade education in rural Mississippi may not have the same quality of education as someone who received a sixth grade education in, say, San Francisco in that age cohort. Additional risk factors include limited economic resources over time, which may affect nutrition and stress. Also, disparities in access to health care. People with little money have very little access to health care over the course of their lifetime. So all of those risk factors may be largely responsible for the ethnic differences in the rates of dementia between African American elders and Caucasian elders in the United States.